FBI, folks. Spider-Man is in fact Peter Parker.
Are you Spider-Man's girlfriend?
In fact,
are you Spider-Man's girlfriend?
Please don't touch her,
sir. You're just a kid?
You murdered Mysterio? Helped him murder Mysterio?
No, I didn't.
Come on, can anybody?
All this time, people looked up to this boy and called him a hero. Well, I'll tell you what I call him. Public enemy number one.
I'm so sorry, but I can't see anything with your hand in my
Dude! Hello, Peter.
Hi? Do I know you?
What have you done with my machine?
Your machine? I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know. What machine?
Do you want to play games?
Catch! Don't worry, ma'am! I'm coming!
Peter!
Give me the box.
No.
Mirror dimension, where I'm in control.
Strange stuff! Can we please just talk about this?
Parker, don't you realize that in the multiverse there are an infinite number of people who know Peter Parker is Spider-Man? And if that spell gets loose, they're all coming here!
Look, I know, I get it, but we can't just send them home to die!
It's their fate. You can't change that any more than you can change who they are.
Whoa, what are you doing?
What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to 55 Fandom. So, this is the night before Christmas. No, I'm joking. The night before Spider-Man No Way Home premieres in the UK. So excited for it. Haven't gone on to Rotten Tomatoes yet. Haven't gone on to any websites. Because I want this film, even though some leaks I covered and I did a load of videos on this film, I don't want the massive leaks to be spoiled to me today when the release for at least people in the UK is tomorrow. So, these are my predictions for Spider-Man No Way Home. And as you saw, I showed you the three clips. Those three clips were released on the internet. So, yeah, those were cool. And it kind of gives you an idea of the film. So, I'm just going to start making predictions. Number one. Biggest prediction, I think Toby and Andrew will be in this film. Now, let me say this again, this isn't confirmed, this is just me, you know, predicting. And maybe I'll get some stuff correct, maybe I won't. So, you know, mild spoilers in case I get something correct. So don't say I didn't warn you, you know. So yeah, I think Toby and Andrew are going to be in this film for sure. I really think so. I mean, Marvel know what the fans want. They've brought Alfred back, they've brought Willem back, they've brought Jamie back. Like, why wouldn't you bring Andrew and Toby back? You need to recuperate money from the pandemic, so I do think they're coming back. Second prediction, I think that all of the villains will slowly be killed off at, like, the end of the film, one by one. Or they'll get, not a happy ending, but they'll get a conclusion. So I think maybe Electro may... So what I mean to say is, in spite of Peter doing all he can to help save them, they die anyway. So I think Electro's gonna die. I think Lizard's gonna die. Sandman's gonna die. I don't think the Green Goblin's gonna die. I think something different's gonna happen to the Green Goblin. And I think Alfred Molina's character will go down a hero. So that kind of leads me on to the third prediction. Alfred Molina will become a good guy at the end of the film. At the end of the film, just like he did in Spider-Man 2. He will not die a monster, as he said in the Spider-Man 2 film. Fourth prediction. What are we on? Fourth prediction. I think Aunt May will die in this film, and Happy will die in this film. I think we'll lose Happy first in the film, and that will be a really punch in the gut moment to Peter. And then at the end, there's this shot in the trailer where the goblin is throwing a bomb at an apartment, and the apartment blows up. I think Peter is trying to save Aunt May, and he doesn't, and Aunt May sadly dies at the hands of the goblin. I think this film will have many consequences for Peter Parker. So I think Aunt May will die, and he's now feeling angry, and Spider-Man doesn't kill. So I don't think he'll kill the goblin, but he'll help the goblin. I think he will try and discover an antidote thing to reverse what the goblin did in the 2002 Raimi film. And I think he will give Willem or Norman that serum, and I think that will help. Although this is just predictions, so be that as it may, I think that is what's going to happen. Fifth prediction is that at the end of this film, no one is going to know who Spider-Man is. The spell is going to have worked, and even Doctor Strange himself will not know who Spider-Man is. And he won't have any access to Stark Tech. And I think at the end of this film, we're going to see a shot where Tom Spider-Man swings off into the daylight by himself. I think we are going to get a scene where he bumps in, or he sees MJ and Ned, and he's just going to kind of leave him alone and go, right, I can't put anyone else in danger after May's death, Happy's death. I'm just going to leave him be. They're happy, and I'm going to go do my Spider-Man thing. And although it will really hurt Peter as a character, I think he will learn from his mistake. I think that Andrew Garfield will come in with a clutch when MJ falls off the bridge. I think he'll come in and Andrew will go, not this time, not like what happened to Gwen. And he's going to save her. And I think that would be a really, really good payoff moment. I also think one of the three Spider-Men is going to die. Obviously, they're not going to kill Tom. They're planning to do more films with him. But I think a lot of people are going to die in this film because we need consequences for this Peter Parker. What people love about Spider-Man and Peter Parker is that no matter how many hits he takes, how many consequences, he always gets back up and he's always Spider-Man. Always. So which Spider-Man would they kill? I think they could kill Andrew's Spider-Man. That's not to say that they will. I think they might do that. They might do that to Andrew's Spider-Man. And maybe there could be this really lovely scene where he's at, you know, he's at Death's Corner and he's going, hey, you know, you guys got your girls. I was wondering if I could, you know, see mine again. I've missed her. And then he goes up into the clouds and, you know, his spirit goes up. I think that obviously we're going to get Doctor Strange v Spider-Man. So I think that by the end of this film, Doctor Strange and Spider-Man will become kind of enemies. Well, not enemies, but they won't be friends, you know? They won't. They really won't be friends. And that's not really a prediction. That's more of just a, oh, yeah, this will happen, because blah-de-blah. I think that's just about it. I think the post-credit scene will have something to do with Venom, because let's face it, where do you go after this? Well, Venom 3 has already been announced. It's in production, which is a video for another time. But where would you go with Spider-Man 4? Easy. Spider-Man versus Venom. So I think Venom will be introduced. And you know who I think will be introduced at the end of the film? Peter will go to college, because that's what he's planning to do. And we'll get a glimpse of the MCU's Gwen Stacy to carry on a new trilogy. Where maybe he just lets Gwen Stacy know he's Spider-Man and he falls in love all over again. Because you can't have Spider-Man 4, 5 and 6 without a love interest, you know? So maybe you could have Gwen, who's Spider-Woman already. So revealing his secret identity wouldn't really be a problem to her because she has spider powers as well. All in all, I'm very, very excited for this film. Coming out tomorrow afternoon, first showing of the night. And let me know what you guys think down in the comments. No spoilers, please, if you're from, like, America or you've seen the film early somehow, please don't spoil it for everyone. But I think this film is going to be massive, and we'll see what I got right. We'll see if I get anything right. I probably won't, but we'll see. But until next time, my friends, bye-bye.